Hello everyone, so I'm Michael Spence and I'm a data scientist at CeADAR. In this video, I will be describing CeADAR's new Lighthouse project in semi-supervised and self-supervised learning. So I'll begin just by giving a brief overview of these two topics, and then I'll describe the general structure and the motivations for the project. So I'll start just by giving a brief recap of machine learning. So machine learning is the act of training a computer to perform some kind of complex task using large amounts of data. This is in contrast to traditional programming methods, where your algorithm is explicitly programmed by someone. So there's two main kinds of machine learning. There's supervised learning and unsupervised learning. Supervised learning uses labeled data. So in this case, if you were trying to classify images based on whether it contained an apple or not, you can see in the diagram here, you need manual annotations telling you which images are apples. And the other kind of machine learning is unsupervised learning. So this is when your data is unlabeled. So this could include tasks such as clustering data based on similarities. So most of the high profile successes of machine learning in recent years have been based off supervised methods using labeled data. But as more and more data is being gathered, thanks to increased storage capacities and big data technology, it's becoming impractical to label all of it, which has led to a lot of activity looking at new techniques which can take advantage of both labeled and unlabeled data. So semi and self-supervised learning are two of these techniques. So the first of these two techniques, semi-supervised learning, it works very similarly to supervised learning in that it's mostly based off labeled data. But what it allows someone to do is it allows you to incorporate unlabeled data into your predictions to help improve their accuracy and their reliability. So using unlabeled data, you can find trends in the data, you can find patterns which can help inform your decisions. One recent example of semi-supervised learning being successfully applied in industry was by a team at Amazon. So using semi-supervised techniques, they managed to increase the performance of Alexa's speech recognition technologies. So the original speech recognition model was trained on about 7,000 hours of labeled speech data. And by using semi-supervised techniques, they were able to incorporate about 1 million hours of unlabeled speech data into their predictions, which resulted in an error reduction of 22%, which is obviously very significant and of great benefit to the company. So this example shows the benefits of semi-supervised learning techniques within industry. So the other topic of this Lighthouse project is self-supervised learning. So this is another method which allows us to take advantage of unlabeled data. So what this consists of is taking some unlabeled data, in this example I've chosen images, and augmenting it in some way, and then training a model to fix this augmentation. The idea is that when training this model, new processing methods will be automatically learned for this data, which take advantage of trends and patterns within the data. So in this example, you would take an image, you would convert it to black and white, and then train a model to convert it from black and white back into color. And the idea is that in this process, you would learn certain things about the data, which would allow you to improve the performance of downstream tasks, such as image classification. One recent example of self-supervised learning being applied in industry to great benefits was recently performed at Google. So Google used self-supervision to train what they call the BERT language system, which is used in many different areas of Google's operations, such as their search, for example. So how this system was trained is shown below in this diagram here. So what they did was they took unlabeled text data, so just sentences, and they dropped a random word within a sentence. So in this case, you have "How are blank doing today?" And the goal of the model was to predict what this missing word could be. So as you can see in this example here, some options have been given you, they, and your. These have been predicted by BERT. And what this allowed BERT to do is it allowed it to automatically learn things about the structure of the English language, which can then be taken advantage of for downstream tasks, such as classifying searches. So BERT was very successful and it's used in nearly all English language searches now. Which again shows the potential of self-supervised learning in industry. So I've just briefly mentioned two successful applications of semi and self-supervised learning in industry, but there are many other areas in which these techniques could prove useful. So if you were running a call center, for example, and you had a large amount of voice recordings which you wanted to extract information from, these two methods could be useful. If you were a legal firm who had a large amount of tax documents you were trying to organize, these methods could also possibly be helpful. If you had a large amount of images, these methods again could be useful. And even if you had purely numerical data, these techniques could also be of benefit potentially. So I've given you a brief summary of the two main topics of this project, and I'll tell you a bit now about the motivation and the structure of the Lighthouse project. So first of all, our main goal is to tell you about these new and emerging technologies which might not be well understood. To do this, we would like to meet you in groups or individually to discuss the potential of these new technologies in your business. We would also like to work with you to produce custom solutions to any problems you might have. We will provide you with the outputs of this project as we progress through it in the form of documents and videos like these. We would also be happy to run workshops for your team to help educate them in these new technologies. And we are also going to provide you with any documentation which comes out of this project. So if you're interested in any of these things, or if you think there's potential for these technologies in your business, then please don't hesitate to contact me. My email is down there at the bottom of the screen. So thank you very much for listening, and I hope to hear from you soon.